up, girls and boys, ladies and gentlemen, it's your girl Christine and I am back here for the final installment of the Battle of the Comedian series that we've got going over at Afrobeats Niger. It's a bittersweet moment, the atmosphere is crazy, there's so much excitement in the air and I'm so sad to see that this is the last one for this year, but I can guarantee you it's going to be the best way to end off the year for anyone. Trust me, stay tuned and just keep watching out for everything that we've got in store for you guys. I'm only giving you behind the scenes access. It's going to be turnt up. There's about to be a situation going on over here and I'm going to cover it for you live from the red carpet here at Lighthouse in Camberwell. Battle of the Comedians.
Come on, say it. Oh, look for me, la la la. Amazing. This song reminds me of 2005. And you remember, you know that year now, when your babe break up with you, you will find an excuse where you want to make the girl fall in love with you, but you begin to sing, oh, don't fool me, yo. Come on, if you know it. Come on. Now, I don't know about those who borrowed ladies here today, but if you have a personal lady, I just want you to hold her now. She said, I'll sing the song. Can you play personal lady for me, please?
Mama things on the beat.
Come on.
Hey, again, I'm here with another backstage exclusive interview with the one and only. He doesn't even need an introduction. I'm going to let him just spit his own fire for you people himself.
My name is Omo King. Omo King 247, all day, every day.
I mean, there's no retreat, no surrender with that one. He's just a king all the time, all the time. Every time we see him, that kingship be that.
My fault now.
Tell the people a bit about yourself, Mr. King.
Yeah, I am Omo King, music producer, artist, singer-songwriter, production company owner, all-time entertainment mogul, really, that's why I am here.
So there's just a whole lot of commas in that job description, right?
Definitely, like, when you're multi-talented, like, you just lay all out, unleash, unleash, really, that's basically it.
I love that. And here at Biological Comedians, we do support the best artists all around in the entertainment industry that do multiple things with themselves. You're definitely a success story. I think there's loads of people in the generation now that just do multiple things at once. They don't think it will work, but I think someone like you and the platform would be great for them to see. So what are you looking forward to tonight, Biological Comedians?
Tonight, it's just all about entertainment, bringing them quality entertainment. And I've been on stage already, I did my thing, and the vibe from the crowd was good. I'm hoping to come back on stage and, yeah, bring it down. Like, entertain people, that's what I'm about, really. Entertain people.
So he's an entertainer, he just wants to entertain. So where can the people find you, Mr. King?
You can find me on all social networks, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, SoundCloud, OmoKings247. OmoKings247. 247. And my website is www.softhouseproductions.com. If you need Afrobeat instrumentals, hip hop, trap, house, EDM, just holler at your boy.
Alright, so Mr. King has said it himself. I can't even add any more ginger into that one. You need to check this guy out. He's definitely another star to watch out for. Here at Afrobeat Niger, we bring you nothing but the best in talent. Stay tuned. Hey my people, what is up? It is your girl, and you know I've got the gist for you here live from the Battle of the Comedians show, October 31st. I'm here with these two beautiful ladies. They are such a knockout, I forgot to ask for their name. So let me do that now. What is your name?
Hey, my name is Angel.
Hey, Angel. Wonderful. What's your name?
I'm Ronke.
Ronke is posing for you guys already. We have to do outfit of the night. Look. Let's just look at the outfit. Look at the outfit. Oh my God. Look at the outfit as well. Look at this one. Oh. These girls look so amazing, honestly, guys. How are you feeling tonight?
We are feeling great, really. We are looking forward to the comedians.
Yeah, that's all. Okay.
And what about you? I'm feeling absolutely fine, and I'm just looking forward to seeing the comedians as well.
That is wonderful, ladies. You look amazing. I hope you guys have a lovely time and enjoy. Really, just laugh. It's going to be a great night. And trust me, I know that they've got loads of stuff in store for you guys. So enjoy yourself. Angel, everyone, okay, my new best friends. I want to be like you guys when I go up. Trust me. Hey, look, Afrobeat Niger.
If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you are fat and you know it, say amen. If you are fat and you know it, say amen. If you're fat and you know it, and you really love your burger. If you are fat and you know it, say amen. Ladies and gentlemen, mommies and daddies, brothers and sisters, God bless all of you for coming out. A.Dot Comedian is the name. And I just want to start by saying I'm very happy to be here today. I'm delighted to be here. But there's an issue that I have. And my problem is some people, they don't know how to have good manners. I don't like people that don't have hope to you. Meet your destiny. Women, you cannot say no to every man, otherwise you will never marry. I spoke to one woman not long ago. I saw her, I said, you know what, this madam, she makes sense. Let me give it a go. As I talked to her, she told me that she's waiting unto the Lord for her husband. And I told her, look, I've come to put an end to that prayer. Because I believe I'm the answer. Still yet. Doesn't give me any chance. And instead of her to just walk on her way, she started to shout. And when she's shouting, she's bringing the attention of the public that doesn't aware of what is going on. And I'm looking at myself and I'm saying, wait, embarrassment is not my portion. Embarrassment is not a part of my destiny. She started to shout, why do you want my number? Can you leave me alone? The spirit of God inside me said, Afolabi, don't tolerate that. As she's shouting, you two begin to shout, add confusion to the situation. I said, can you give me your number? She said, I don't want to give you my number. I said, but can you give me your number? Everybody walking by now, they just crossed the road. They say, you know what? There's something going on there. And I now talk to her for a second. I've never in your life been to that again. That's silly behavior. And I left them there and I took them.
I just put them.
Women in the house, women.
Bounce screw, that's all.
Understand something. You are very powerful in your brain. Mm-hmm. And I don't like that. But whether I like it or not, that's the situation. That's not going to change. When a man asks you for your number in a public place and you don't want to give it to him, you don't have to. It's wisdom. It's wisdom you will use. If you are rude, this is 2015. The respect from men to women nowadays has gone in the bin. It's not the way it was before. When a man is talking to you and you don't want to give out your number, just be very nice about it. You do something like this. Hello, excuse me, sorry. I know you want my number, but I'm not interested. I like women. I don't want men in my life. I've had so many men, so now I'm on the chapter of women in my life. You say something like that. Some of you have no manners. You are not even 10 out of 10. Somebody is trying to lift your spirit and rectify your destiny. And you are giving attitude. You will remain simple. Understand something? You see, all the men in the house, can you say yes?
Yes.
Men, let me tell you something. Let me help you. Men, as men, we jump to conclusions too early in our lives. When we go out, like this is a good example. When you look around this venue now, many kinds. And what do? When we are with our friends, we like to select the one we like, and we leave the one that is not good for our friends to take. First come, first serve. That's the way men operate. But sometimes, as men, we jump to conclusions. We already come to a conclusion that, yes, this one I'm going for, she is the best of the bunch. This one, 10 out of 10. But we haven't seen her face. The only thing we have seen is the products and services from behind. You can see the pounded yam is ready, made, and fresh. Based on that, we just talk to our friend and we just have a quick conversation with them. We say, my brother, this one over here, this is for me. Please just wait back. Don't be an enemy of progress. Allow me to do what I need to do. Your own time will come, please. So now you walk over to her. But as you are walking over to her, you have a question in your mind. A good question, and that question is, excuse me, love, do you have a name to match your beauty? Very solid question. So gentlemen, you can save that one in your diary. As we are walking towards her, I'm going towards her. I'm so happy. I'm smiling. I'm looking at my friends for some good luck. They are telling me good luck. I said, God be with you. I'm also walking towards this lady. Ladies and gentlemen, remember I am smiling and I want to ask her, excuse me now, do you have a name to match your beauty? But I walk towards her, ladies and gentlemen, and I tap her on the shoulder. I said I tapped her on the shoulder. Now she turned around to me. You know, automatically, I realized that the question I had planned before doesn't make sense for me. Because I've never ever seen such a tsunami on the face of a human being before. But because I've tapped her now, I have to ask her something. Communication must happen. I've tapped her, she turned around and said, wow, excuse me, how do you get to Manchester? Moral behind that man, gentlemen, never ever just jump to conclusion. You have to make sure that it is what you think it is fully. Can't just go and commit. All the parents in the house, where are you? Make some noise. Parents that enjoy beating their children for no reason. Make some noise, where are you? God forgive you.
Hey, it's your girl Christine and I'm here with another app behind the scenes with the one and only UK champion himself, A.Dot Comedian. How are you, sir?
We give God the glory, I'm fine. I can't complain. How are you?
I am tired, bro. I'm good. I'm having fun. I saw you on stage and I had to abandon my work. I was supposed to interview someone, I just left them standing there. I was like, wait, I'm coming. Uncle A.Dot is on stage. I have to, let me just catch fun once more like that. I was on stage for you tonight.
It's very enjoyable. The crowd have come out to enjoy themselves. So I just went there, say one or two things that they can relate to, and we connect on the stage as like magnets, and they laugh, and I do what I need to do, and it's good. Everybody enjoy themselves.
I saw some guys taking notes on your relationship tips. And
very important, because things are going funny for men nowadays, and I don't want any men to enter trouble again, which is why I explain what I explain on the stage.
So where can people keep in touch with you and keep track on what you're up to and what you're doing in London?
That's a good question. I'm on social media handles. You can catch me on the Instagram, Snappers Chat, I've just joined that one. YouTube, I'm there as well. Twitter, I'm there, A.Dot Comedian. That's A.D.O.T. Comedian. And if you don't remember anything I just said, just go to A.Dot Comedian.com. So that's where you have to go to keep up to date with me. Especially Instagram, because I post everything there as well.
All the men in the house that have been rejected before in their life, say yes. Some men want to deceive themselves. I saw one guy at the back, his friend was poking him. Charlie, you are supposed to make noise. Men, sometimes you have to accept it. When you get rejected, sometimes there's no way out. You just walk away. But I'm not the type you can reject. I'm not the type. Because I'm not a fool. If I talk to you and you refuse to cooperate, I will just urinate on it. Hello? Can anybody clap for this DJ, please?
Okay.
DJ Spence! Spence, Spence. My brother, play me something, please. Because you want to be, wait, wait, because you want to be involved, we are going to test his ability. DJ Spencer, I want to give you a scenario now. You are just about to be successfully deported. You don't know how to speak English. The only thing you can play is music. What do you play? Ladies and gentlemen, if you like it, say enjoyment. If you don't like it, say nonsense. My brother, can you play deportation for me? Deportation. They are just about to successfully deport you. You only know music. What do you play to let people know you are in trouble? My brother, I'm offended. Okay, let me give him another one. Okay, all right. 1 to DJ and 0 to ADOS already. No problem. My brother, you are going out now. You are going out now with your girlfriend. She has offered to pay for the meal. But you have told her, don't worry, babe. I have this covered. You get to Nando's and your card has successfully declined. My brother, you will not be lost in your life. Ladies and gentlemen, ADOT Commander is my name. I thought I would come back and give you some more. God bless you and enjoy the rest of your night. Once again, social media, ADOT Commander. God bless you.
Hey guys, I am with the one and only Stunnah Gee. How are you, sir?
I'm very fine, thank you. Yeah.
You look so... Swag is not even the word for it. The swag is just, it's overflowing, it's overflowing. You know when swag becomes swag, you gotta add a little je ne sais quoi to it.
You know what she said? Swag. Yeah, next time you see me, you gonna see me on grills, baby. Grills.
Nah, just playing, man. Just
so how have you found the night so far?
Well, to be honest, I don't even know what's happening tonight, man. I just rolled in right now, man, with my crew. How about that? So I don't even know what's been happening, man. But yeah, we're right here now, we're here now. So we're about to turn things upside down, make it look like you say you understand, we're shutting down the place. But it's not us that's going to shut down the place, it's everybody that's going to shut down the place. Are you feeling me?
Okay, so where can the people find you online, social media?
Stunnah Gee now, everywhere, Stunnah Gee. People keep spelling my name wrong and it pisses me off. So I'm going to spell it right for you. First and last.
Introduction, public service announcement. Stop spelling his damn name wrong. Okay, spell his name right, okay?
Please.
He's not just anybody, okay?
Exactly.
It's the one and only Stunnah Gee.
Okay, sure, as you say.
Oh, amen, amen.
But I'll spell my name for you guys. It's S-T-U-N-N-A-H. Put a H behind my stunner. I'm not a stunner. And I'm not a stunner. I'm Stunnah Gee, G-double-E. So, add Stunnah Gee on all social network platforms. So, catch me, find me. Add me, I don't know, just support the movement. It's about to be big, baby, and I'm saying so.
You heard it here first on Afrobeat Niger. It is about to be big. Make sure you follow him on all social media, Stunnah Gee. Signing out. I'm gonna make you mine.
honey. Oh Lord, today, baby, jingle for me. You know you love me now. Ladies and gentlemen, this is my heart for you. This is what I do. Just to please you guys, man. I love you wholeheartedly. You're one. Bless it. You know what I'm saying? Don't drink too much. I'll see you next time, brother. Make some noise.
We give a voice to him. Stunnah is his name. Can I get one, please? We're running out of time. But we're still going to keep it alive. We're going to sing on Aphrican Ape. Ready to crush it. The awards, please. Listen. DJ Kill it.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, I'm the voice of this name. You're coming by this name.
October, we conducted, we had a voting system put in place, online voting system for promoters, best promoters, first, second, third, and DJ as well. Well, I'm so sorry because time is not in our hands. So, by popular demand, you have voted, they voted, everyone voted here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'll call on Cordelia to come on stage to present the best DJ awards for me tonight. Don't ask me why. Cordelia, come on stage. Now, I'll tell you something. Like I said, next year, Battle of Comedian 2, we'll go finest comedian here in the building tonight. But just a quick one, just 2 minutes, and we're out. All right, now. Let's say find your ladies now. Wow. Somebody say wow. Get out of here. Now, listen. Right. The public has voted. Number one DJ in UK. Finest DJ, baddest DJ, first and the best, DJ Unbeatable! Your boy DJ Unbeatable. On behalf of Sojaboi, we present this award to you. Are you happy as a winner? Thank you. Do you want to say something to them? What do you mean?
Thank you, thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you, presented to you by Cornelia Sojaboi. Present the best DJ, the runner. Thank you, give it. Ladies and gentlemen, and distinguished guests, on behalf of myself, the whole entire world, the public voted, not me, runner up and the best, second, final DJ, DJ Tony!
I want to
to thank everyone for coming out tonight, for supporting the movement. As I said, Basketball will be here next year, and who again? Basketball will be Kevin out, alright. Look here, neighbor, and say, these people are sleeping. Please say to your neighbor, Say again, Thank you, guys, man. Thank you.
Thank you, Digitalis, man. Can't get it on his life. It was over. Congratulations, brother, man. Now, promoters!
Hey, it is your girl, Christine, and I'm here with one of the mega acts for tonight, Aphrican Ape. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
I said it right this time, right?
Close enough.
Okay, next time you have to just teach me.
Right, I got you.
Cool. How are you feeling? Are you excited?
Absolutely. I'm ready to go, man. I'm fired up, ready to go.
Yeah, I love the outfit, like the whole black thing and the glasses too. I want sunglasses as well, guys. I really want to learn his swag. I want to swag like him. Oh my God. So what most are you looking forward to for tonight?
The love. I'm looking forward to the love. You know, it's always good to get a lot of love. That love is what gets me going and keeps me pushing. So the love so far has been amazing. You see that? That's love right there. That's why I do what I do, you know, so it's amazing.
Just standing next to you, I feel like a celebrity, but it's not me, it's him. Alright, enjoy yourself tonight. I can't wait to see you up on that stage. I can't wait to see you interact with your fans and everything. Go out there and kill it. Alright, stay lit. That's for me, Nigel. Bring you all the best.
What's your name? My name? Listen, no, my father's name. It's when you get to immigration, they'll ask you one question, you'll be answering the one they didn't ask you. They say, what are you here in London for? I said, it's my father that said I should come here. It's ridiculous. But all that, once I enter London, boom, I'm already happy. So let me tell you what happened. Soon as the lady said, okay, welcome to London, you can go. I said, go. The next thing I heard was, hello? Yeah, man, help us, Nimowa, help us. I say, my Nigerian people, inside airport again, you shall always know them. It's very ridiculous. The man was trying to act familiar with me. He said, excuse me, are you Nigerian? I said, I don't know you. He said, I don't know you. You know, the one thing I learned about London is everybody here says, in it. Get right here to your father. If I give you this mic, let's see what you can come and say. Everlasting bastard. Idiot. You know, I'm telling you, man, it's ridiculous. But you see, like, I've been in America for 10 years. And I'll tell you something about myself. First of all, if you had to get a visa to enter London, please make some noise right now. Come on, you guys are liars. There are people here that had to get visa. All of you cannot be citizens. If you had to get visa to enter London, make some noise! Okay, now if you got that visa the very first time you applied, make some noise. Thunder fire, I love you. Because the visa struggle is not easy. Some of us had to apply for visa multiple times. Me personally, I applied for visa 1,001 times, they didn't give me. I applied, they denied me. It got so bad, one particular time, I didn't even apply. They still denied me. I said, what's the meaning of this rubbish? That day, I just went to the mailbox. I saw a letter from American Embassy. I pulled out the letter. I saw American Embassy. I was excited. I thought they had changed their mind and they want to give me this visa. I said, come and join me, sing hallelujah. I read the letter. The letter said, we are very sorry, sir. We have to deny your application at this time. What application? I didn't apply again. So I grabbed my phone. I called them. I said, hello, American Embassy. What do you mean deny my application? I didn't apply again. They said, yes, sir, we know you didn't apply again, but we know you will soon apply again. So I deny you in advance. We call that prepared denial. I said, the devil is a liar. But finally, I entered America. Somebody shout hallelujah. Okay, now when I got to America, I started suffering different set of challenges. Because, you know, Africa is very different from America. And, you know, this is London, so London and America, they go hand in hand. So Africa is different from London as well. Now the first thing I learned that was very different was the name. You know, back home we all have long names. Oluwa so imi dotinu waju amota. Onokamepo onuwaju Oluwa. Those are regular names for us. So I got to America thinking my name was regular, but I was wrong. Because their names are extremely short. You see somebody, Bob,
Mike, Ashley, I met somebody, his name was Jay. He said, what's that? He said, that's my name. I said, you are not well. So the first day in class, the teacher was going down the roll call. He said, Ashley, present. Bob, present. Nicole, present. Jay, present. This man carried the roll call. He put it by the light. You know how you're trying to see something will make more sense. 5 minutes, he couldn't say my name. He said, he couldn't say my name, he couldn't spell it. He said, O-L-U-W-A-D. I said, present. He said, wow, how do you pronounce your name? I said, are you ready? He said, yes. I said, are you ready? He said, yes. He said, well, my name is Oluwa Damilola Bola Washola, Abotun Yola Itola. He said, oh my gosh! Is there something shorter I can call you? I said, you can just call me Damilola for short. He said, that's still too long. Give me something shorter. I said, my friend, shut up. I already divided my name by half and you are still complaining. What else do you want me to do? I left class that day. I didn't go back for the entire semester. That everlasting bastard gave me an F. I had to carry that F to my African father at home. Exactly. You think you are looking at me now? It's my spirit you are looking at. My father killed me many years ago. Because you know African parents, their own grade scale is very different. In an African home, A is for average. B is for below average. C is can't come back home. D is don't even bother. F, you are finished. You are finished. You know, that's an African parent's grade scale for you. It's very ridiculous. So that was the first challenge I had in America. Now the second challenge was with directions. Because you know, in America, London, everything is so orderly. Everything is boom, boom. Straight to the point. But in Africa, scatter, scatter is the order of the day. If you are driving your car, and you see the road is just free, no traffic, no problem, you won't go that road, you'll go back. Ah, wala wabi yo. I'm not going that way, I'm going back. That's what happens in Nigeria. And in Africa, period.
Hello.
Hey, 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 it's your girl Christine, and we are just kicking things off here at Lighthouse in Camberwell at Battle of the Comedians tonight. Right, I've got these two wonderful ladies, Tolu and Nikki, right? Sorry, okay. How are you guys doing?
No, I'm doing great, thanks. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you, sweetheart. And yourself?
I'm fabulous.
So what are you guys looking forward to for tonight?
A.Dot Comedian, of course.
Yeah.
Okay,
what about you?
Aphrican Ape and A.Dot.
Okay, I think we should keep a tally of this. So far, we've got two for A.Dot and one for Aphrican Ape. I think they're both going to deliver. They do really well typically all the time anyway. You guys are going to have an amazing time. I can tell you, I've like seen some of their stuff already. I've been sneaking into rehearsals and stuff. I've seen what they're going to do. It's going to be an amazing time. Make sure you guys at home keep it locked and look out for all of the behind the scenes stuff that we're going to bring to you live from Afrobeat Niger here at Battle of the Comedians on the 31st of October. Stay tuned. Hello, how are you?
Not too bad, I'm alright. You?
Fine, thank you. And yourself?
I'm alright, thank you.
She has a lovely name. Her name is Shalom. I love that. It's so amazing. You guys, I love your outfits. When I saw you came in the door, I was like, England. England, no one needs it. Jay.
Actually.
So what happened?
Because we've been losing too many times now. We thought we have to change.
You guys are loyal. No. Okay, so what are you guys looking forward to for tonight's show? So you can quickly get back home and catch up on what you've been missing. What are you guys looking forward to?
Just a bit of fun, laughter.
Okay.
I'll say same, just to relax and have a nice time tonight, yeah.
Battle of the Comedians is a place to be if you want to relax and have fun before going to watch your football matches. What do you do? Who are you look, which acts are you looking forward to most?
I'm not actually sure who's performing. I'm just gonna, yeah, it's gonna be a nice surprise.
We're gonna establish some new favourites for you today. And what about yourself? Do you know anyone that's here?
Yeah, Crazy Clown, Tega and Shea Nigga.
Okay, I'm sure we'll be able to deliver for you guys, especially you, but you don't know anyone here. We'll establish some favourites for you and you guys can, and hopefully you guys win something, seeing as you abandoned your original team.
Yeah. Just for tonight.
Just for tonight. Okay, they're not loyal for one night only. Here at Battle of the Comedians, I'm getting all of the gist of Afrobeat Niger. Stay tuned. How are you, ladies?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. So you're hiring yourself?
I'm good, thank you.
This one has such a pretty smile. They were so shy. They wanted to run from me. I don't think I take no prisoners here. Afrobeat Niger, I am catching every single person that walks through that door. Right, ladies, who are you looking forward to?
Aphrican Ape.
Aphrican. Everyone's been saying that he's a favorite. What about you?
Aphrican Ape.
Oh, Aphrican Ape, just here. You have two major supporters here.
Praise
Camberwell.
Oh, yeah, I like him too. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Chris. No worries. Both of them, I'm sure they're going to deliver. I've heard a bit of, you know, what they're getting up to, and it's going to be an amazing night. Yeah, I heard you guys are in VIP.
Yeah.
Oh, shoulder wristband. Oh, yes. Oh,
imagine my own.
Oh, yes. Kill it. Anyway, ladies, have an amazing night and enjoy yourself. When you're in VIP, remember me.
Remember me.
See you guys.
Bye.
Hey, guys, what is up? It is Christine, and I'm here again on behalf of Afrobeat Niger here at Battle of the Comedian Show. Of course, I've got these wonderful women here with me. So glamorous, so beautiful. How are you ladies doing?
Fine. Yes, I'm good.
Yeah. Okay, ladies, what are you looking for to for tonight?
Right, I'm here because of Sojaboi, who is the presenter, and also I'm after Opolopo, or what's it called?
Yeah, I'm here to look for that.
And all the artists, I'm sure I'm going to enjoy today.
Yeah. Okay, and what about you?
I came here to enjoy myself.
That is what, we've got all of that in store and more. I love your outfits, you all look so amazing. Where's your outfit from?
Debenhams.
Oh guys, fashion finds here, Debenhams, this is amazing. Ladies, you're going to have such a great time. I know that Sojaboi and all of them are going to deliver, and I can't wait to see you guys in the crowd laughing. I'd be like, those are my aunties, they're wonderful. Remember me.
And I will let you know what are you girls.
Okay. Wonderful. Okay, ladies, have a great time.
Enjoy. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome.
You're not going to play music, huh? Hello, everybody, how? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Ooh, the Oyinbo boy, the lad. Oyinbo people make some noise. They don't even know the Oyinbo. White people make some noise. Look at them strategically placed. They all came together, but they said spread out. I love performing in the UK to Nigerian audiences, because when I perform to predominantly white audiences and I talk about my experiences of Nigerian culture, it just so it's nice to actually feel like I'm in Nigeria. This is what it's like in Nigeria. You know, when you go back to Nigeria, you land at Lagos International. No matter what time of the day that you land, when you come out, it looks like this. There's just people standing there. They're not picking anyone up, they are just, you know, they are dead. I love Nigeria, I've been to Nigeria 11 times. 11 times, man. I should just move there, right? I should just go and live there. I even get there, man. I love Nigeria, man. I love Nigerian culture. The first time I fell in love with Nigerian culture was when I was an early teen, like 13. I was in Tesco's and I was trying to steal something. And the security guard was Nigerian, right? And he stopped me, and I was young and cocky, so I wanted to try and fight with the security guard, right? I wanted to fight him, I don't know why, right? And that was when I realized that Nigerians don't fight like any other race. Like, when you get into a fight with a white guy, it's very animated, isn't it? Oh, come on, yeah! And they're shouting, but yeah, you fucking are, you here? Even if they're not fighting someone, they'll hit themselves to look like they've been in a fight. So that they get sympathy. Caribbeans now, the Caribbeans fight. You don't understand what they're saying, but you're still. I don't know what you're saying, Leroy, but I'm scared. So now I'm in Tesco's, right? And this Nigerian security guard is saying to me that I've stole something, so I'm trying to fight him. I pushed him. I'm like, this fight, and he's like, I don't want to fight. He's like, what? You don't want to fight? He said, I don't want to fight. I was like, why don't you want to fight? He said, because God is good. That positive twist, right? Sometimes he says, God is good. I was young and very ignorant, right? I'm like, God is good. I pushed him again, right? He's like, honestly, I don't want to fight. Please, I don't want to fight. I left, right? I left. Left there, like, yeah, I beat him up. I won. And my friend who was with me when we got home, he said, Kev, they know when you left. I was like, yeah. He said, security guard did something. I don't understand what it was. I was like, what did he do? He's like, well, when you left, he just beat your hair. And he said, with this whole hair, I will beat everyone. I said, I like that. He's fighting me, I don't even know. I love that. Again, I get asked to perform at a lot of Nigerian weddings, man, and I love Nigerian weddings because when Nigerians do a wedding, right, they know how to do a wedding. Like, it's like they go through the book of other nations' weddings, like what the British people do. Oh, no better than that. What did the Jamaicans do? Not much. But then they go to the Ghanaian page. What do the Ghanaians do? We will double that. And they do. Like, I went to this one Nigerian wedding, right? The buffet was crazy. Like, from here to here was just one way. I didn't realize, I didn't understand the culture. They were spraying the bride dollars. Spraying about the bride, they were hitting her. She thought she was fly. She's like, hey, spray me. The money was hitting her. And she must have been wealthy because she weren't picking it up, right? She just made it hit the floor. Now me, I'm from the hood. I was like, I'll take that. She was like, leave on. I remember being too comfortable in Nigeria, and I started traveling there, and I got complacent. I was like, yeah, I like this place. And I started learning little tricks, you know what I mean? Because Nigerians, you're very clever, man. You know how to do things. Like, I learned from the other guys that I was hanging around with in Nigeria ways to not get mugged. How beautiful is that? I had a really nice watch. I was walking in Lagos, two guys come up to me and start saying, they're trying to rob me. Like, yeah, give us your watch. I was like, hey, this watch, you know, you know, I get that from Alaba Market. Alaba Market, that's where you can get everything, man. You can get Gucci with Louis Vuitton print. You know, man, hey! Louis Gucci. I remember taking an internal flight in Nigeria. That was an experience. Because the international airport, that's one airport, isn't it? That's like, hey, you're doing well. And when you're taking an internal flight, no, it's not from here, go next door. I went next door, we was flying to Benin, right? And we was on board. And it was fun, I was performing there with Basket Mouth, right? A huge comedian, Basket Mouth. And I never forget the first time I met Basket Mouth. I was here in London, and he was booking me for a show there, and we met for the meeting, and he was dressed in a suit, looked very professional, like on point, speaking the Queen's English. Kevin J, we would like to book you for a gig in Nigeria. Very nice, gave me confidence. When I landed in Nigeria, he was there to pick me up, just standing outside in one yeah gloves like that. We got Okada. Let's go. I said, Basket, you sold me a dream. So I was flying to Berlin with him, right? And we're in the air, right? And something happened that I hadn't experienced before. The pilot came on, right? Came on the tunnel. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a 40-minute flight, but today there's a delay. There's no electricity in Berlin airport, so we are just going to fly around. We're just flying for like 3 hours. I'll let you know when he comes back. My experience on airplanes are kind of like quite well known, man. That experience when I was flying to Nigeria with Eric. I love Eric, man. Big up Eric. Just don't employ Nigerian pilots. They're too honest. I remember I was leaving from Heathrow, right? I got on board and I was sitting down and there was a delay, right? And the people on the flight were blaming me. They were like, the engineer is still here. You have to leave. Engineer, why are you sitting down? You are delaying the whole team. It's like, no, I'm not an engineer, I'm coming with you. Woo! Yeah, great. So I flew to Nigeria for the first time, and the pilot came on the tunnel. And I knew something was wrong from the beginning, right? Because he boarded from the back of the plane. And I was like, why is he boarding from the back? And the reason why, ladies and gentlemen, was because he's a proud Nigerian man. He's a pilot. He studied to be a pilot, and he wants everyone on his flight to know he's the pilot. So he walked from the back to the front, dragging his suitcase, stopping every now and then, letting people know, I'm your pilot, your life is in my hands. If I crash, you will die. If I don't, you will live, right? And people were like saying, oh, thank you, sir. Come on, what are you saying thank you to him for? It's his job, man. And then he goes in the cockpit and makes an announcement. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome aboard this flight to... Where are we going? Welcome aboard this flight to Lagos. Today we are going to be flying at a height of about 15,000 to 35,000 feet. I haven't decided yet. But please, by all means, make yourselves comfortable. And we will take off when I'm ready. And we did like an hour late, we were watching Breaking Bad. I'm like, dude, you're awesome, man. You're awesome. 2.5 hours into the flight, he comes back on the tarmac. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a small, small problem. We have a small, small problem. Please do not be alarmed. Do not be alarmed. One of the engines is leaking oil. At that point, right, I was alarmed, right? I was really scared. I didn't know what to do. The people around me, they just like praying, you know, and that's fine, you know, you can pray, but the kind of prayer that I was hearing, I hadn't heard before, like the auntie sitting next to me, she just like praying war prayer. I didn't know what war prayer was until that day. Lord Jesus Christ, whatever demon is trying to penetrate this aircraft today, Heavenly Father, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, just cover this whole plane with the blood of Jesus. I was like, the blood of Jesus? What the fuck is he done, right? But sometimes when you don't feel like you're fitting in, you just do anything to fit in. So I just got involved with her. I was like, Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus Christ. Save us, mate! Save us! And it was like, we like, you know your mates. This is God we are talking about. Oh man. Like I said, I've been there like 10 times, man. I've been there 10 times, traveling around, going different places. I did a show in Port Harcourt. I did a show in Port Harcourt, man. Basket Man said to me when he was traveling there, when we get there, do not leave the hotel without me. I said, why, Basket? He said, because they take white people here. I was like, what do you mean they take white people? If you're white, they will take you. Alright, okay. Now, I don't know if I'm brave or foolish, right? But I went into my hotel room and there was no bottled water.